Pittsburgh was able to get out most of the time with relative ease. And
well, Matt Cook ran into DiPietro. And now the Islanders come to their goaltender's aid. Remember, Cook is the guy who delivered the dirty hit, or so most people in hockey thought, on Mark Savard last year. And I don't know if, whoa, Rick DiPietro wants Johnson here. I don't know how much of that was initiated by DiPietro, but DiPietro and Johnson. And Johnson put Rick down quickly, and with all of Rick's assorted physical problems, I don't know why, other than the obvious answer, which would be abject frustration, he felt he needed to do this. And if he's making a point feeling that some of his players were pushed around or took some shots they shouldn't have tonight, starting with Talbot's hit against Blake Como, well, that's great. But, you know, when you're Rick and you've had the physical situations that he's had in the past, I can understand him trying to make a point, but there might be other ways to do it.
Well, there's no doubt that he's, you know, frustrated at the game. And and that Rick DiPietro was...
Ricky looked like he initiated that one.
Yeah, I think he did initiate a little bit, trying to get, you know, up Fox Talbot a little bit. Watch this as he sticks the stick out a little bit. Talbot could have could have avoided him. There's no doubt about that. He didn't have to go anywhere near DP. So, I mean, but this here, I don't understand what Rick's doing. Obviously very frustrated. As I said, Johnson is 6'3". DiPietro's only 5'11", so it's a little bit of a reach. Johnson's been around a while. I don't know if he's fought before, but certainly landed a good hard left on DiPietro there.
With just 16.5 seconds remaining, and Rick, he says, all right, let's go. He's making an appointment with Johnson while that stuff in the corner was going on.
Yeah, Johnson certainly wanted a piece of him, and boy, that's a solid left. I mean, Johnson had crossed center ice already, so that's an automatic...